हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर YouTube चैनल 3D पैरामेट्रिक सॉलिड मॉडल ड्राइंग्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू क्रिएट एन असेंबली फाइल ऑफ सस्पेंशन इन ऑटोडेस्क इन्वेंटर। द डिजाइन ऑफ द मॉडल सस्पेंशन हैज बीन टेकन फ्रॉम असेंबली फाइल ऑफ सस्पेंशन सैंपल फाइल्स ऑटोडेस्क इन्वेंटर। Now we are showing some pics of this model that you can imagine, understand that what will look like the assembly is made. If you want to get the file of this model, then I have given the link address in the description of my video. By visiting that link, you can get it easily. Now you can see here, this is my part list of suspension assembly. This assembly contains several parts. Okay. Okay, that's it. First of all, we will create a standard inch assembly file. Okay. Now we will activate the place component command. Okay, all right. Now select the front side plate right model. Okay, and place in the assembly. Now select the place grounded at origin option. Okay. Now this part is fully defined in this assembly. There is no need to give any mates over this part. Now go to the View tab and the Settings button. Okay. Import the custom light from here. And increase the brightness of the model from here. Now see, my assembly is very bright. Save the assembly with the name Suspension Assembly. Okay, that's it. Now place the part file front side plate left in this assembly. Now we will activate the constrain command. By seeing the tooltip of constrain tool, you will understand how this tool works. Now we will choose the flush option. Okay. Select the face of front side plate right and left and apply flush mate. Okay. Rotate the model in this position. Select this face and this face and apply another flush mate. Okay. In the solution area, choose mate option and select the whole of front side plate right and select the whole of front side plate left. Okay. Now see. Drag the part from here. Now activate the place component command and select the front upper arm mount. Okay, and place into this assembly. Okay. Now choose front view. Now select front upper arm mount part file and activate the free rotate command. Okay, rotate the part in this position. Now we will activate the constrain command and select this face of front upper arm mount. Okay, and select the back face of front side plate. Okay, and apply the mate constraint between them. Okay, drag the part from here, select this face of the part and this face of the front upper arm mount. Okay, and apply another mate constraint. Now drag the part from here, now we will activate another place constraint between this face of the part and this face of the front upper arm mount. Okay, and apply the mate constraint. Now drag the front slide plate left part from here, select this face of front upper arm mount and this face of front side plate part. Okay, save the assembly. Now we will activate the constraint command, select the top face of this part and select the bottom face of this part and apply and set the offset distance value between these two parts. It will keep 0.09375 inches. Okay, that's it. Now see the result. Now we will activate the place component command and place the part file front shock brace. Okay, all right. Choose front view, select this part and activate the free rotate command and rotate the model in this position. Now activate the constraint command, select the whole of this part and select this hole and apply mate constraint. Now we will apply another mate constraint between this hole and this hole. Okay, that's it. Select this face of the model and this face of the front shock brace, apply another mate constraint between these two parts. Okay, all right. Now we will create another new inch assembly. Okay. Activate the place component command. Go to the suspension folder. And place the part front upper arm. Okay. Choose place grounded at origin option. Okay. Now my part is fully defined in this assembly. Now go to the view tab and activate the custom light command. Okay. Now import the custom color style from here. Now we will add one more light. Okay. And increase the brightness of the model. Okay. That's it. My part is looking very bright. Now we will activate the place component command and place the part pillow ball in this assembly. Okay, that's it. Now activate the constraint command and select the cylindrical face of pillow ball part and the whole of front upper arm and apply the mate constraint. Okay, now select the center point of this pillow ball part. okay, and this face, and set the offset distance value 0.35 inches. Okay, now see. Save the assembly with the name front upper arm. Okay, all right. Now we will create another new inch assembly file. Okay, and place the part front lower arm in this assembly. Now we will increase the brightness of my model from here. Okay. And place another part, pillow ball, in this assembly. Now we will apply the same constraint over this assembly that we had done previously. Okay. And save this assembly with the name front lower arm. Okay, all right. Close this assembly and close this assembly. Now activate the place component command and choose front upper arm assembly. Okay, and place this assembly in my suspension assembly. Okay, all right. Rotate the model in this position by using the free rotate command. Okay, now we will activate the constraint command and select the cylindrical face of this hole and cylindrical face of this hole and apply mate constraint. Select this face of the hole and back face of the front upper arm mount and apply another mate constraint. Okay, that's it. Now see the result. Now my front upper arm assembly is moving on. Now we will place the front lower arm in my suspension assembly. Okay, that's it. And apply the same constraint that we had done previously over the front upper arm mount. Now see the result. Now my front lower arm assembly is moving on here. Okay. That's it. Okay, now we will place the copy of front upper arm assembly in my suspension assembly. Okay, and apply the mate constraint between the hole of this assembly and this hole of front upper arm mount. Okay, create another mate constraint between this hole face and this face of front upper arm mount. Okay, and apply the mate constraint. Rotate the assembly from here. Now we will place a copy of front lower arm assembly in my suspension assembly and apply the same mate constraint that we had done earlier. Select this face of the part and this face of the part and apply mate constraint. Now you can see here my four arms has been fixed over the suspension assembly. Okay, that's it. Now we will activate the place component command. Choose the front lower arm brace and place into the assembly. Okay, alright. Now we will activate the constraint command. Select the whole face of front lower arm brace part and select the whole face of front lower arm. Okay, and mate constraint between them. Now see. Drag this part from here. Now activate the constraint command once again and select this hole and this hole. Okay. Now we will place the two front lower hinge pins in this assembly. Okay. Now we will activate the constraint command. Select the cylindrical face of this pin and this hole and apply mate constraint. In the same manner, we will apply the same mate over the opposite side. Apply another mate constraint between the face of the front lower arm and the back face of the front lower arm brace. Okay, that's it. Now see, my front lower arm brace has been fixed over this suspension assembly. Okay, it's fully defined. Select the flush mate from here. Select this slot face of the pin and select the front face of the lower arm brace. In the same manner, we will apply another flush mate over the opposite side. Okay, alright. Okay, alright. Now see, my two front lower hinge pins are placed in my suspension assembly. Okay, that's it. Save the assembly. Okay. Now we will place the two front upper hinge pins in this assembly. Okay. Same constraints will be applied on these pins that we had done previously over the previous pins. Okay, now see the result. Now we will place the 8 E-clips in the assembly. Now see. Now activate the constraint command and select the cylindrical face of E-clip and pin and apply mate constraint. Now see the result. Okay, alright. Now we will another mate constraint between E-clip and pin. Okay. In the same way, we have fixed more E-clips over the suspension assembly like this. Okay, now my all the eclipse has been fixed. Save the assembly. Now we will place the part front suspension adjustment clip in the assembly. Okay, place one more clip on here. Now we will activate the constraint command. Select this face of clip and this face of upper arm mount and apply mate constraint between them. Now we will select the cylindrical face of this clip and lower arm and apply the axis mate. Okay, now see the result. In the same manner, we will fix the second front suspension adjustment clip over the opposite side of the suspension model. Okay, all right. Now we will place the two copies of shock bushing part in the assembly. Activate the constraint command. Select the front face of this part and select the back face of shock bushing and apply the mate constraint. Okay. Select this cylindrical face and this face and apply another mate. Now we are going to create another new inch assembly file, okay, and place the part ball end in this newly created assembly. Save this assembly with the name ball end assembly. Insert the part file 0.25 ball. Okay. Now we will activate the constraint command and apply the mate constraint between XY plane of these two parts. Now see the result. My 0.25 ball part is placed into the center of the ball end part. And apply another mate constraint between this cylindrical face and this face. Okay, now my assembly is fully defined. Now we are going to create another new inch assembly file. Okay, place the part shock shaft in the assembly. Okay. Save the assembly with the name it as shock strut assembly. Now we will activate the place component command. Place the part piston in this assembly. Select this cylindrical face of pin and this cylindrical face of piston and apply axis mate between them. OK. Drag the part from here. Place the part E-clip in this assembly. Place another copy of this part. And apply the mate constraint like this. Now select the flush mate. Select the front face of piston and slot face of shock shaft and apply flush mate. OK. Now we will place the assembly of ball end. Apply the mate constraint between face of ball end assembly and this slot face of shaft. OK. Select the cylindrical face of pin and ball end and apply axis mate between them. Now we will place the part spring cup in this assembly. OK, that's it. Now we will activate the constraint command. Select the back face of spring cup. And select the front face of shock shaft and apply the mate constraint. OK. Select this cylindrical face and this cylindrical face and apply axis mate. Now rotate the model from here. And save the assembly. Now we will create another new inch assembly. OK. And place the file shock voltage in this assembly. Select the place grounded at origin option. Now see my part is fully defined. Now we will increase the brightness of this model. OK, it looks great. Now we will place the part O-ring in this assembly. OK, now activate the constraint command and select this axis of O-ring and this cylindrical face of shock cartridge and apply mate constraint. OK, drag the part from here. Now go to the filter option in the browse bar and select the model view. OK, go to the O-ring part and open the visibility of work plane 1, OK, and open the visibility of work plane 2, OK. Now we will activate the constraint command. Select this plane of O-ring, OK. Select this face of shock voltage and apply mate constraint. OK, that's it. Now activate the place component command. And place the shop voltage spacer in this assembly. Okay, activate the constraint command, select this cylindrical face of shock voltage spacer and this cylindrical face of shock voltage. Okay, and apply mate constraint between them. Drag the shock voltage spacer from here. Now go to the view tab and activate the half section view from here. Okay, select the YZ plane. Okay, now see the result. Activate the constraint command and select this plane. Okay, and select this face. Okay, now see the result. Now close the visibility of these planes. Go to the browse bar and choose assembly view option. Now we will save this assembly with the name shock voltage assembly. Okay, that's it. Now we will place the part shock voltage cover in this assembly. Okay, all right. Create another copy of O-ring part and apply the mate constraint between this axis of O-ring and this axis of shock voltage. Okay. Choose model view option and activate the constraint command. Now select the work plane 1 of the O-ring and choose front view. Rotate the model in this position and select this face of shock voltage spacer and apply the mate constraint. Okay, that's it. Now we will activate the constraint command and select the whole axis of shock voltage cover and select the outer cylindrical face of the shock voltage and apply the axis mate between them. Rotate the shock voltage cover in this position. Select this face and the inside face of the part and apply the mate constraint between them. Okay, that's it. Now go to the shock voltage space part. And change the color of this part as brindle. Okay. Go back in the assembly mode. Save the assembly. And choose end section view button. Now we will create another new inch assembly from here. And place the part file shock body 1.3 length in the assembly. Okay, that's it. Now we will activate the insert component command and insert the shock voltage assembly from here and select the cylindrical face of shock body length and shock voltage assembly and apply mate constraint between them. Okay, that's it. Drag the assembly from here. Activate the constraint command, select this face of shock body length and this face of shock voltage and apply mate constraint. Now select the angle mate from here, Select this face of shock body length and this face of shock cartridge assembly. In the solution area, select the directed angle option and apply angle mate between them. Okay, now see my shock cartridge assembly is fully defined. Save this assembly with the name shock body. Okay, alright. Now we will create a new inch assembly from here. And place the part file shock spring adjustment nut in the assembly. Okay, rotate the model in this position. Now we will increase the brightness of the model from here. It looks good. Save the file with the name shock absorber assembly. Okay, that's it. Now we will place the PAR file suspension spring in this assembly. Okay, alright. Now activate the free rotate command. Select this spring and rotate the part in this position. Choose the isometric view. Now we will activate the constraint command. Select the cylindrical face of adjustment nut and select Y axis of the spring and apply axis mate between them. Now see the result. Save the assembly. Now we will place the shock body assembly file in this shock absorber assembly. Okay, that's it. Now rotate the shock body assembly in this position by using free rotate command. Okay, alright. Now we will activate the constraint command. Select the whole face of shock spring adjustment nut and select the outer cylindrical face of the shock body assembly and apply mate constraint between them. Now see the result. Now choose the flush mate from here and select the front face of shock body assembly and shock spring adjustment nut and apply the flush mate between them. The offset distance value between these two assemblies, it will keep -0.4003 inches. Okay, that's it. Now we will activate the constraint command and choose the angle mate. Choose directed angle option from here and select these two faces of the assemblies. Okay, now see the result. Now my assembly is fully defined and save the assembly. Now we will place the assembly shock strut in this assembly. Rotate this assembly, something look like this. Okay, alright. Activate the constraint command and select the rod of shock strut assembly. Select the cylindrical face of shock body assembly. Okay, and apply the mate constraint between them. Drag the assembly from here. Apply the mate constraint between the face of spring and the back face of shock strut assembly. Okay, that's it. Now we will give the angle made between this face and this face. Okay. Now go to the View tab, activate the Slice Graphics command by selecting the XY plane. Now we will create three new positional representations in this assembly. First of all, we will create open position, and second is closed, and third will mid. Okay, alright. Each mate will be given on the inside of the separate positional representations. Each assembly has a master positional representation that represents the default state of the assembly. Where modeling operations take place, you cannot edit the master positional representation, but all new positional representations are copies of the master. You make changes to each as needed and then reactivate the master positional representation to save the assembly. Suppose in the first case, if you want to enable the open constraint at a time, but close and mid constraint will be suppressed. Okay, alright. In the second case, this time if you want to enable the mid constraint at a time, but this time open and closed constraints will be suppressed. The positional representation helps for showing the different states of the assembly at a time. This tool is very helpful. Okay, that's it. Now drag the assembly on this position. Now we will go to the representations folder in the browse bar. Okay, select position option, right click and choose new button. Okay, now see my new position 1 has been created here. Now change the name of this position. Set the name open. Okay. Now activate the master position on here. Now we will activate the constraint command. Okay. Select this face of E-clip. Okay. Rotate the model. And select this face of shock body assembly. Okay. And apply the mid constraint between them. Now we will go in the shock strut assembly. Now choose this mate. Now select this mate and change the name of the mate. Mate open. Okay. That's it. Now select this mate open. Okay, and choose right click and choose suppress option. Okay, now we will activate the open positional representation. All right and select this mate open, right click and activate the override option. Now you can see here override object mate open dialog box is visible here. Now place the check mark in the suppression option. Now choose the enable option from here. Okay. Now save the assembly. Now we will select the master position and click the new button. Okay, alright. Change the name of this position, it as closed. Now we will activate the master position, activate the mate constraint command and select this face of pin. And this face of shock body assembly and apply the mate constraint between them. Okay, that's it. Now select this mate and change the name it as mate closed. And this mate will be suppressed. Now we will activate the closed position from here. Select the mate close and choose override option. Okay. Now place the check mark in the suppression area and select the enable option. Okay. Now we will create another new position from here. Set the name middle. Now we will activate the master position. Now we will drag the spring from here and activate the mate constraint command. Select this face of shock spring adjustment nut and this face of spring and apply the mate constraint between them. Okay, that's it. Now go to the shock spring adjustment nut and change the name of this mate 7. It will keep as a mate mid. This mate will be suppressed. Now we will activate the middle position from here. Select the mate mid and choose override option. Now place the check mark in the suppression area and select the enable option. Okay, alright. Now go to the view tab and deactivate the section view from here. Now you can see my three positional representations are created. Okay, that's it. Now we will test these positional representations one by one. Now we will activate the first position. Now see the result. Activate the second position. Now see the result. Activate the third position. Now see the result. Now go to the master position. Okay, alright. Now my shock absorber assembly has been completed here. This is ready to place it my suspension assembly. Save the assembly. Close all the assemblies. Okay, that's it. Now we will activate the place component command and place the shock absorber assembly in my suspension assembly. Okay, that's it. Rotate the shock absorber assembly in this position by selecting the free rotate command. Activate the mate constraint command and apply the mate constraint between the back face of shock absorber assembly and the front face of shock bushing. Okay. And apply the axis mate between the hole of shock absorber and shock bushing. Now drag the shock absorber in this position. Select this assembly and go to the representation option. Choose the middle position from here. Now see the result. Now my shock absorber assembly is fixed over my suspension model. Choose the isometric view. Now place another copy of this shock absorber assembly from here. And give the same mates on this assembly that we had done previously. Okay, that's it. Save the suspension assembly. Now we will create a new inch assembly. Okay, and place the component. Front hub carrier left in this assembly. Okay, choose place grounded at origin option. Now my assembly is fully defined. Okay. Now we will increase the brightness of this model from here. Okay, that's it. Now we will insert the pillow ball bushing and pillow ball retainer part in this assembly. Okay, now see. Activate the constraint command, select this face of the pillow ball bushing. And this face of pillow ball retainer and apply mate constraint between them. Now select this cylindrical face and this face and apply axis mate between them. Now activate the constraint command. Select this cylindrical face of pillow ball bushing and this cylindrical face of front hub carrier left and apply axis mate between them. Okay, now see the result. Place another mate constraint between this face and this surface. Okay, now see here my pillow ball bushing and pillow ball retainer are fixed over the front hub carrier left. Save the assembly with the name Front Hub Carrier Left. Okay, that's it. Now we will place the one more copies of these two parts. Apply the same constraints over the opposite side of front hub carrier left part. Okay, now my assembly is fully defined. Now we will place the part rear hub bearing in this assembly. Now activate the constraint command and choose the insert mate from here. Now select the outer edge of bearing and rotate the model and select the inner edge of front hub carrier left and apply insert mate between them. Now my bearing is fixed on over the inside of the front hub carrier left. Now we will place the part front axle in this assembly. Okay, activate the mate command and select this cylindrical face of front axle and the whole axis and apply the axis mate between them. Now we will place the part front hub bearing in this assembly. Okay, that's it. Drag the front axle part from here and apply the insert mate between back outer edge of bearing and front inner circular edge of front hub carrier left. Okay, now see the result. My front hub bearing is fixed over the front hub carrier left. Apply another mate constraint between this face of the bearing and back face of front axle. Okay, that's it. Now see, my front axle is moving on his axis. Now we will place the part 0.1875 ball stud in the assembly. Now we will apply the insert mate look like this. Now we will create an inch assembly from here. Okay, activate the place component command and insert the part file hex drive in this assembly. Okay, now see. Now go to the view tab and increase the brightness of this model from here. Okay, that's it. Now we will place the part hex axle pin in this assembly. Okay. Now place another part file in this assembly. Choose hex retaining O-ring. Okay. Now activate the constraint command and select this axis of pin and this whole axis and apply mate constraint. Okay. Now my pin is placed over the center of the hex drive. Now select the Z-axis of hex O-ring and select this whole axis and apply the axis mate between these two parts. Now we will select the XZ plane of hex retaining O-ring and select the XY plane of hex drive and apply mate constraint. Now see, my hex retaining O-ring has been placed over the center of the hex drive. Now we will save this assembly with the name rear hex hub assembly. Okay, alright. Close this assembly. Activate the place component command and place the rear hex hub assembly on here. Now activate the constraint command and select this cylindrical face of front axle and this whole face of the assembly and apply the axis mate between them. Okay, now rotate the model. Select this axis of pin and this whole axis of front axle and apply another axis mate between them. Okay, now see the result. Choose front view. Now we will create another new inch assembly file and place the part file wheel in this assembly. Okay, choose place grounded at origin option from here. Now my wheel is fully defined in this assembly. Now go to the view tab and choose settings option and import the custom favorite color from here. Okay, now my wheel is looking very fine. Activate the place component command. Now we will place the part tire 2 in this wheel assembly. Okay, that's it. Now rotate the tire 2 in this position by selecting the free rotate command. Okay. Choose top view from the view cube. Okay, rotate the tire in this position. Now we will activate the constraint command and choose insert mate option. Okay, select this edge of tire 2 and select this edge of wheel and apply the insert mate between them. Okay, now see the result. Now we will activate the constraint command. Go to the tire 2 part and select the XY plane of the wheel and select the XY plane of wheel. Okay. Now we will save this assembly with the name wheel assembly. Okay, that's it. Okay, now my tire 2 is fully defined. Close this assembly. Now we will activate the place component command and select the wheel assembly. Now we will change the name of the wheel assembly, name it as wheel left, and place the wheel left assembly into the newly created this assembly. Now activate the constraint command. Now we will select this cylindrical face of front axle and select the whole axis of wheel and apply mate constraint. Okay, now see the result. drag the wheel assembly. Now we will activate the constraint command. Now select this face of rear hex hub assembly and select this hexagon face of the wheel. Okay, all right, and apply mate constraint. Okay, select this face of hexagon of the wheel assembly and select this hexagonal face of the rear hex hub assembly. Okay, and apply the mate constraint. Now rotate the model in this position. Now we will place this part in this assembly. Okay, all right. Now we will activate the constraint command and select this cylindrical face of front axle and select this whole face of nut and apply mate constraint. Okay. Now rotate the nut in this position. And close the visibility of wheel assembly. Okay, drag the nut from here and open the visibility of wheel assembly once again. And activate the constraint command. Select this whole face of wheel and select this face of nut and apply mate constraint. Okay, that's it. Now we will create another new inch assembly file from here. Okay, activate the place component command and place the part file front hub carrier right in this assembly. Okay, all right. Now we will place the two parts such as pillow ball bushing and pillow ball retainer in this newly created assembly and another copy of these parts in this assembly. Same constraints will be applied in this assembly that we had done earlier on my previous assembly. Front hub carrier left. We will make this assembly in the same way as we had made it earlier. But this assembly of the name will be changed as a front hub carrier right. Okay, that's it. ओके असेंबली मेट्स आर कंप्लीटेड हियर नाउ सी द रिजल्ट माय असेंबली इज फुली डिफाइंड. Now we will open the wheel left assembly and save as this assembly with the new name wheel right assembly. Okay, that's it. And place the wheel right assembly file into this assembly. Now we will also give the mates on this wheel assembly that we had done earlier on my previous assembly front hub carrier left. Now my assembly has been completed. This assembly is ready to place in my suspension assembly. Close all the sub-assemblies. Return back to the suspension assembly. Now we will activate the place component command and place the front hub carrier left assembly in my suspension assembly. Okay, all right. Now rotate the wheel assembly in this position. Okay, that's it. Now we will activate the constraint command. And select the center point of pillow ball part and select this center point of front hub carrier left part and apply the mid constraint between them. Okay, that's it. Now drag the wheel assembly from here and another mid constraint between this center point and this point. Okay, that's it. Now we will place the front hub carrier right assembly in my suspension assembly. Now rotate the wheel assembly in this position. And apply the same mates on this wheel assembly. Okay, now both the wheels are fixed over my suspension assembly. save this assembly. Now see, my suspension assembly is looking very nice. Now we will place this bolt in this assembly. Okay, alright. And apply the mid constraint between this center point of the bolt and this center point. Okay, now see the result. In the same way, we will fix another bolt in my suspension assembly. Now we will place the two washers in this assembly. Select the hole of washer and select the cylindrical face of the bolt and apply the axis mate between them. Now we will fix another washer over the opposite side of the model. Okay, now see. Now we will place the two nuts of this bolt in this assembly. Okay. Now we will apply the axis mate between nut and bolt. Select the front face of washer and select the back face of the nut and apply another mate constraint. Now we will place another bolt in this assembly. Rotate the bolt in this position. Now we will activate the constraint command and select this cylindrical face of bolt and whole face of shock absorber assembly and apply the axis mate between them. Apply the same constraint between the bolt and shock absorber assembly over the opposite side of the model. Okay, alright. Now we will apply another mate constraint between this face of the bolt and front lower arm assembly. Okay, that's it. Now my shock absorber assembly is fixed on the suspension assembly. Okay, in the same manner, we will fix the second shock absorber assembly by using mate command. Now my both the shock absorber assemblies has been properly fixed over my suspension assembly. Okay, that's it. Drag the bolt from here. Now we will place the two washers in this assembly and later we will fix these washers into the bolts. Drag the washer and bolt from here. Now we will give some more mates in these bolts so that the bolt has properly placed into the assembly. Now we will place the four copies of this bolt. And afterwards, we will fix off these bolts over the front upper arm mount by using the mate command. Now go to the representations folder. Now we will create two positional representations on the suspension assembly. Create a new position, name it as right bump on here. Okay, activate this right bump position. Now select this shock absorber assembly. Right click and choose override option. Place the check mark in the positional representations field and choose closed option from here. Okay, now see the result. Choose front view. And activate the master position. Now see the result. Activate the right bump position once again. Now see the result. Finally, my suspension assembly has completed on here. Okay, that's it. Now choose the isometric view and save the assembly. I hope you will like this video. If you may like this video, please like and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest updates. Please share this video with your friends and colleagues. Okay, friends, goodbye.